this.
Have you ever thought that you might be able to use a love coach? Whether you're dating casually, getting married, or you've been married for a long time, there are always ways to improve our relationships. Annie Lala is a relationship expert who's appeared on the new Bravo series Misadvised, where she has helped the show's stars tackle their own love lives. Among clients, she's also known as the cartographer of love. We'll explain that in a moment. Here with the do's and don'ts to know before the big day, please welcome Annie Lala. How are you? You look so gorgeous. How are you doing? It's nice to meet you. Have a seat. So I read a little bit about your background, and it was fascinating. You studied philosophy, you studied biology, mm-hmm. and you put this all together as what we're calling a love coach, a cartographer of love. What does that mean?
Well, a cartographer is a map maker.
Right.
So I see love as this vast, complicated terrain, and I've been studying it for a long time and mapping it out, so when people find themselves in these landscapes, they have a way to navigate. And I help them navigate through their own lovescape.
Well, one of the things that people always ask is, what should I know before I get married? What things do we need to talk about or work out that maybe you just don't anticipate
yep.
when you're very young? Mm-hmm. What would you advise?
I think one of the first things you want to talk about is where you're going to live. Okay, you want to align with your partner on what kind of weather you want to be in. Do you want to be in the city? You want to be in the country? What kind of living environment do you want to be in? Because if you're not aligned on that, it's going to just cause problems later. So you want to have that talk up front.
Right.
Where you want to live. Also, what are you going to do with your life? What's your purpose? What's the vision? How do you both want to create value in the world and make a contribution together or individually? So where you're going to live, what you're going to do. And the third thing I would think you want to talk about is whether you want to have kids.
Yeah.
Yes to kids, no to kids, how many, when do you want to have them, how do you want to raise them? It's a really important topic. And I also recommend that couples, before they commit to a long-term relationship or get married, to sit down and create a future vision map of mm-hmm. how you want the relationship to look. Like, what is partnership going to look like for you both? And how would you collaborate to create a vision that works for both of you based on your mutual values and your needs and your wants?
I would guess a lot of things would come out of those discussions.
Yeah,
that you might
we don't
not
have these discussions.
About.
People just get married and they never talk about it.
Yeah, exactly. And there's also a problem of, you know, drama around
yes.
a wedding.
Yes.
What are your recommendations for navigating through that in a peaceful way?
You know, to be honest, I've never met a couple that were in love and getting married that didn't have mad drama the 2 months before the wedding.
Maybe that's just
including
part of the
me.
Deal.
I'm happily married, in love, and it was probably one of the most hectic times we've ever had.
Yeah.
So you think about it, it's the first joint project you're doing together. You have different wants and needs, different ideas, different levels of perfectionism, and you're trying to make this joint venture, and it's a perfect opportunity to practice collaboration and sitting down and going, well, what do I need and want? What do you need and want? Where's the overlap? And that collaborative process is really important, so I would encourage people to remember one thing. The wedding is a decoration for the true love relationship. Don't mix them up in importance. Keep your priorities. Sometimes you can get obsessed, and the wedding becomes more important than the fact that we're angry at each other. We're upset
yeah.
right now, and, you know, the
it's
woman or the man.
It's a partnership and a marriage that you're creating, not a party. Not that it's not important.
Well, the party's
but,
great,
yeah.
but it's a decoration for the
right.
the decision to get married is something you make with your heart, and it's done in here.
Yeah.
Everything else is decorative.
Speaking of that decision, I mean, lots of couples are living together, lots of couples are choosing not to get married
yes.
or to have kids without being married.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a question now. It's not just who you want to marry and when you want to marry, but if you want to marry.
Yeah.
And not always do the man and woman feel the same way about
yeah.
this. So what is your recommendation for really having that discussion if you are in a serious relationship and it sort of looks like your partner's not interested in whatever you're interested in? How do you go about dealing with that?
You know, I get a lot of women who just want to get married. They go, Annie, I just want to get married. I want to get married in the next year. And I'm like, honey, the most important thing, and this is why I do the work I do, is to be in love. Falling in love is the point. Marriage is something you can decide together with your partner. And if it's something you really want, you represent it to him. You represent it with your heart. And you don't make your love relationship contingent. Because what I see a lot of women do is they go, look, I want to get married. And it's been, you know, 2 years, and you haven't proposed to me, and we're not committed, and you better ask me to marry me or else. And there's this ultimatum looming. And I
That's
really...
That's so romantic.
Oh, it's so not romantic. it's the opposite of love. It's tyrannical. And so what I recommend women do is make sure your man knows that if you love him, you want to be with him no matter what.
But what
whether
if
you're
you
married
don't?
Or not.
What if you really don't want to? What if you really do want to get married and have kids?
Well, then you can find someone to get married and have kids with, but then give up on this idea of love because they're not the same. Marriage is something you can do with someone you're in love with, and if love doesn't come first, the marriage is not going to be sustainable, it's not going to be long-term, and it's not going to be fulfilling.
If you know that person doesn't have the same life goal of marriage and family, is it appropriate to say, you know, I'm sorry, I love you, but I have a different vision for my life?
Well, that's a tough one, because when I fell in love with my partner, he wasn't interested in kids, he wasn't interested in marriage, he didn't even believe in love. And so I systematically just kept representing, well, I really want to be with you. I'm in love with you. If we don't get married, it's okay. Let's stay open to the kids. Are you totally closed? He wasn't totally closed. So I was like, okay, there's something to work with here. And the thing is, I was in love with him, and I was going to be with him no matter what. And because that was true, and he could tell that he was more important than my desire to have a marriage, my desire to want to be married to him just kept asserting itself without leverage, without contingency, and eventually he wanted to get married himself. So if I had just given up on him because he was kind of hesitant, I would have given up on the love of my life. And now we're happily married and having a kid.
Wow,
yes.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Good for you, congratulations. So tell us about Misadvised. This is a really interesting idea for a show.
Misadvised, well, so it's about three relationship experts. One's a journalist, one's a radio talk show, and one's a matchmaker, and they're in three different cities. And I'm actually the real love coach for the journalist. She's my client.
Yes, because they're having trouble with their situation.
It's documenting their dating life and what's working, what's not working. And the truth is, even though they give advice, they're struggling themselves.
Right.
And so I'm brought in to kind of help her navigate this labyrinthine terrain. And one of her things is she's struggling with being authentic and transparent, and she's got a shtick. And so during one of her dates, I said to her, well, beforehand, I said, I'm going to strip you of your shtick. You're not allowed to ask questions, you're not allowed to laugh, and you're not allowed to lean forward. Three things that she does compulsively. So during the date, she had to literally lean back, be receptive, not over-eager, which is what I call queening, the receptive space where you allow your king to serve you, and you know, you're in repose.
I'm going to give this a try at home tonight. I'll report back tomorrow. Should be very interesting. Tim, just be prepared. That's all I'm saying. But it is nice to sort of break out of your regular routine, especially if you've had the same experience or the same bad relationship in a row. You know, maybe the common denominator is something you're contributing, and changing up your whatever you call it, shtick, or your approach to this is a good thing to do.
Absolutely. I mean, love relationships is a forum where you get to reinvent yourself. In romance is the one place where all of your dark and your beauties come out. And so your partner is a mirror to reflect back to you what works in the way you live your life and what doesn't, and what's holding you back from your next level of development. If you allow your partner to be that reflection, then your relationship becomes a crucible for transforming yourself into the most extraordinary version of you possible, which is the point of love.
Aspirational. I love it. Thank you very much. We appreciate you being here.